Welcome to TLC's ongoing daily devotional. Isaiah 43, verses 18 to 19 says, "Remember not the former things, nor consider the things of old. Behold, I am doing a new thing. Now it springs forth. Do you not perceive it? I will make a way in the wilderness and rivers in the desert." Over the last few months, we heard of a virus that spread across the entire world. It turned everything into chaos and our lives were turned upside down. Now, as things are cooling down, we seem to be going back to what was normal. I'm going to say something a little controversial. I don't want the normal. I don't want to go back to normal. You see, as Christians, we went through a period where we as Christians seem very similar to the world. We did what the world did. We ate where the world ate. We shopped where the world shopped. We watched what the world watches on TV as well. What makes us different as Christians? During COVID, during the last situation, during the crisis, we saw prayer in our church go up so many times. We've seen prayer meeting after prayer meeting, week after week, where almost there doesn't seem to be a single day that is free. Life groups are meeting. People are meeting God. The word is being spread. People are asking questions. Kids, even the youth, are asking, what is God having to do? What is God's role in this time, in this period? We see the ability to witness and to share, to give an encouraging word, increasing. What happened during COVID was a new thing. Paul Rutkins in his TED Talk says, "If you do what is normal, you will get normal results. But we want extraordinary results." And breakthrough innovations happen when you break the standards in their industry. The verse says, "Remember not the former things, nor consider the things of old. Behold, I am doing a new thing." This speaker is not anything new for us believers. So what does that mean for us? There is a term going around saying a new normal. Brothers and sisters, what is our new normal going to be? What are the things that Jesus and God has promised? We are promised things unheard of, rivers in the desert. So be excited, be ready. We cannot stay where we are, nor can we go backwards. The only direction we can go is forward, as it was said. So let's move on and keep our eyes focused on God and grow and embrace this new thing that God has done. And not be satisfied with the things of the past, the things of 5 years, 10 years, 20 years before. We have a mandate as Christians. So let us go forward in that as it was commanded in the end of Matthew, the Great Commission to make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, Son, and Spirit. So let us do this. Let us not settle for the old things of the past, but look excitedly and then with full anticipation to the future and to what God has been doing, is doing, and will do. May God bless you. Father God, we thank you for this day. We thank you for what you have done in our church, Lord, what you've done collectively, corporately, and individually. Let us not be satisfied with the things of the past. Let us in one accord, together, hand in hand with the elders, the council members, deacons, leaders of the church, members of the church, together move forward with one accord and not be satisfied with what is of the old, but excitedly and in anticipation move forward in what you have anointed us and called us to do. Thank you for blessing us. Thank you for giving us this vision and this mandate. Help us, Lord, one another, to strengthen one another as we go forward in this new normal. We praise and we thank you. In Christ's matchless and mighty name we pray. Amen. May God bless you. Keep safe and take care.